Blender's particle systems has its problems, especially in regards to its micromanagement. Say you've got a fire made of three particles, smoke, flame, and embers. Want to change when the fire starts and ends? That's six values you have to individually alter. Want a second fire somewhere else? Now you have to make a duplicate and set another six values. Say you have a particle that loops 20 times. That's 19 copies you have to make. Say you want to change the timing, or now you have 14 values to change. If you have a particle system that uses three particles together, like the fire, that's 120 values you have to go through and change, just to move the looping particle through time. Imagine setting up a muzzle flash on a machine gun, or creating dust on the ground when a character makes a step. There's also a bigger problem, in that you have to make these particles a single user copy in order to have them play at different times, meaning that if you need to change any of the other settings, you have to delete every single one of the other particles and remake them again. Be pestered no longer. It's time for particle groups to guide your hand. As the name suggests, it groups particles together. There's a single start frame value, which is used to declare when the particle systems it contains should begin. Particle systems stored within these groups can each have their own offset and duration, allowing you full control over the timing of these particles, while still having all of them reference the same root particle. What this means is that if you want to make a change, you can just go ahead and change the original. Click Generate or Generate and Bake in the particle groups, and all will be updated, without you having to change each of them yourself. You can add a particle group with the plus button here, and in the list beneath, press the plus again to add individual particle effects. If your scene has no particles, this drop-down will be empty. You can add particles in the standard way. Add whichever you want and press Generate. And behold, for the selected particles, emerge. Below that is the settings for the specific particle systems. Rather than a start time, end time, and number of particles, we just have a duration, which is how many frames the particles will spawn for, and frequency, which is the number of particles spawned every frame. The advantage of this is consistency. With a stop and start frame and a number, as in the default, after you've figured out what the number value should be, if you want to change the start and end time, you have to work it all out again. With this, you simply adjust frequency to a level you're happy with, and then it doesn't matter what you set the duration to, it'll stay consistent. In the list, there's also this offset value, which is used to move the start of the particle system in relation to the start time set for the particle group itself. This is in case you need one of the particles to spawn earlier or later than the others. Beneath, there's even settings to have the particles loop. Just tick the button, put loop gap to how many frames there should be between each loop, and loop count to how many times it should loop, or to zero if you want it to loop until the end of the scene. And there you have it. There's also a random offset, which moves the frame at which the particle system starts by this amount or less randomly. Want everything cleared away? There's an easy Clear Particles button. Want to hide the particles from the viewport and the render? A single click can take care of that. One small cautionary word is that you shouldn't try to add manual particle systems to an object which has particle groups, as they're liable to be overridden and deleted. Store all your particles on separate objects throughout the scene, and have the particle groups reference them instead. You also have the streamlined ability to share particle groups between many objects, making the creation and editing of duplicates effortless. See the tutorial linked for how to use this, although it works in much the same way as the particle settings here do. If you're familiar with that process, this process will also come easy to you. With these few humble tools, the chore of handling a large number of particle systems becomes a joy. Be thwarted no longer in your journey for particle proficiency. Lend particle groups your burden, and exhume your exacerbation.